I'm going to talk to you today about a huge government fail, and that is emotional support animals. Now, why do I say that emotional support animals is a huge government fail? Here's the deal. In the United States, which is the only place I'm really comfortable discussing, I don't know about habits in other places, but in the United States, a lot of people own dogs and cats. And if you ask them why, and you kind of just interview them for a minute, it comes down to they get fun feelings. They enjoy the animal. It's for their emotions. They want to be happy. They want to be happy, I think is the best word. They want to be relaxed. When you're around dogs or a cat, it cheers you up. It makes you smile. It makes you happy. I've had a pet for most of my adult life. When I was renting, of course I didn't. That's ridiculous because you reduce the number of places that you can rent by 90%. But ever since I've owned a home, I've owned pets and I love them. So here's the deal. Basically, it's a violent thing. So if I have an emotional support animal, which is what my dog is, and I decide I want to violate the preferences of other property owners, let's say an airplane or a restaurant or a hotel or a landlord, somebody like that. If I don't want to go by the rules that they have thought about and decided that they're going to have on their private property, and yet I don't want to argue with them about it, I want somebody else to use their big guy force to threaten the other person that, hey, you better let Shepard do whatever he wants to do. If that's what I want, then I would have to go to the government and say, hey, my emotional support animal here, will you please make sure everybody will let me do whatever I want with them? Or, you know, let me take them onto their property. Well, that's not very nice of me. If a restaurant owner doesn't want me to have a dog in there, I shouldn't be able to force them to. Same thing with a landlord. So what some squirrely people have done is they've convinced the people calling themselves government to make these laws saying that, in a landlord, for example, if I'm a landlord and somebody wants to live in my house that I'm renting out and they have an emotional support animal, I can't charge them an extra pet deposit or animal deposit. If that, and of course, with the way courts work, they go in favor of the tenant, not the landlord. So you kind of have to set deposits up to cover yourself. But if the animal comes in and does $5,000 worth of damage and the deposit was $1,000 or $2,000, landlord's out. And that's ridiculous. That's just ridiculous. If a restaurant doesn't want a dog in there, shouldn't go there. There should be no third party government that comes in and says, no, you have to do this. So you can go online, you can get this emotional support animal prescription from a therapist who'll give you a 15-minute online interview. And then you get the certificate, and I don't know what it is, $50, $100. You get the certificate, and then now you're using that certificate as force against people to do what they don't want you to do on their property. That's the truth. Now, there are a few people out there, maybe 5%, 10% of the people that have emotional support animals that really truly have some stuff going on in the head. And they really truly are comforted and calmed more than the other 98% of people that have animals. Maybe they really need it or they're going to go nuts. However, if that's the case, you need to go to a restaurant that allows animals. And you need to find an apartment that allows animals. You don't go and use force against other people because you want to have an emotional support animal with you. That's crazy. Now, what isn't an emotional support animal? I'd say there might be a couple thousand, 5 or 10,000 animals in the country that are not emotional support animals. That would be a working cattle dog. He's not really the buddy to the rancher. He's good at rounding up cattle. It saves him money from having to hire a human being to do it. Sled dogs, the ones that pull those. Maybe a police dog. A protective dog. So there are a few dogs out there in the country that are not emotional support. But all the rest of them, mine included, they're there because I enjoy them. My dog's lazy as can be. He likes to play and eat. And he costs us money. He's there because we get fun emotions. We love him. So I'm okay with you having an emotional support animal, but to get that certificate and then use it or use whatever rights it gives you against other property owners, that's messed up. You shouldn't be doing that, really.